Okay, we are installing SIP electric ignition. First thing that goes on is the stator plate. You put the stator plate on the plate, and you align the three screw holes. You can just about see the three screw holes being aligned. You can see the three holes from the back better. You align them from these three holes here, and if you can see through them, then the stator is aligned to the plate. One thing that you have to be careful about is that you do not pinch this cable, the black cable that you can see between the plate and the stator. So there will be a bit of a overlap, but that's fine. as long as the cable is not overly being pinched between the plate and the stator. You'll find various fitting bolts and nuts in here. The three screws are given in here. You should put thread locking on it, but I don't have anything available at the moment, so I'm going to put them without it. Before completely tightening it, I'll give it another quick check. That's how far the cable has been caught between the two. You can see it here. But this is fine because I don't see it being any more squashed than what it is, and there is no other way of putting it in. That's the only place where you can put it in. If you try to realign these three bolts anywhere else, then you get a much larger portion of the cables getting caught between the stator and the stator plate. Now I'm tightening them really tight, going one by one. Do bear in mind the plate at the bottom is made of aluminum, so you can only tighten it to a certain limit. You will not need these screws. The one normally come with Vesper on stator plate. A good idea is to change the Woodruff key at this stage as well. Then the trick is to put these three cables or these five cables through the cable hole. On a newer versions, on a newer machines like around 76, 75, this is, by the way, a VLB 1T engine from, I think it is around a 1976 Vesper Velos engine. I normally put the cables with the thickest head first so they can clear out, and then I put the rest of the cables through. This is a bit of a fiddle to put them through, but one has to do something about them. I would have much preferred them not to have put all these connectors on, so I could then cut the cables to my preferences, and it's certainly a lot easier to put these cables through when they don't have any connectors on the other end. What I'm doing wrong is I'm pulling the cable backward at the same time trying to feed it forward, and what I have now is that all five cables are jammed in which will be a bit difficult to put through, but I think it should be okay. On these newer models, the holes are slightly bigger than the VBBs. So let's see, hopefully it will be okay. And I will not have to pull them through with another cable. Okay, so let's pull them out and see what happens. Yeah, it's working. It's just this white one. Okay, well, certainly a lot more easier than the VBB. VBB are indeed a pain in the neck to put through. Got these cables on, not really aligning very well. We do it like this then. Okay, much easier. Okay, so now I don't know if you can see it or not, but here on the crankcase we have a mark. Okay, down here. I don't want to move the camera and I don't want to move the, I can't lift the engine either, but down here you have this mark, and this is the mark that you have to align in these, with these marks on the stator plate. You will see there will be a bunch of marks here, a scale made here, and you just align it in the middle of this scale, and then you check for the fitment in the crankcase. In my case it is fitting in like a glove. Then you reach out for these screws. They have these disc shape washers and Allen key bolts, basically to put maximum pressure on high quality machine stuff. So you put these ones through,